Rajat has nearly 11 years of industrial IT experience, a bachelor's degree in information technology, and various certifications including tool, language, process, etc. He is responsible for creating and aligning experts to skill metrics, active participant of various conferences across the globe, major contributor for creating organizational assets of L&T Infotech Limited, including IP, approaches, processes, etc. He has won several accolades for his various contributions towards project delivery, innovation cell, and many other things. Please give a big round of applause to Rajat. Incidentally, guys, let me also tell you that the conference was such that we had invited proposals, and we want that going forward, more and more participation happens from the guys who are being delegates. So what we have also seen is that that participation is something that would really take you to the next level. So one of the core mantras for other conferences that we are seeing, like for example, we are hosting a very large conference in Pune in April. And right now the call for papers is on. That conference is on 22, 23 and 24th of April. It's the website is gtr.agiletestingalliance.org. It's Global Testing Retreat. Right now there are around 50 plus proposals coming from all across the globe. So we have got papers coming in from Uruguay, UK, Israel, and a host of other Indian companies. There are more than 120 US as well. So there are more than 120 companies who are participating in that competition. And we want all of you to basically look at the website. So I'm going to repeat it again. It's G as in Ganges, George, G-T-R, T for Tom, R for Richard, dot Agile Testing Alliance, dot O-R-G. Now the last date for paper submission is 28th of March, which means that between now and 28th, if you can think about a topic, they're only asking to you to submit an abstract. If there is a unique idea, please do it. So I would request teams from Allscript and their NetWeb and many other companies sitting out here should submit the paper. Why don't you go and come out and also participate in conferences other than Baroda? So we have got basically Pawan, who participated in one of the conferences in Bangalore for us. And he is now in Vadodara, and he is also planning to put in a paper for the Pune conference. I had a conversation with him during the break, and there's a large contingent sitting out there from Automation Anywhere. Guys, we want you to participate in the Pune conference as well. Now, why I'm saying all this is, Rajat is actually one of the very few. Well, there were two or three people. In fact, the proposals were many. He got selected in the proposal that he submitted. So this is a proposal that came in through the invitation. And Rajat's paper was basically, and we requested him to make it a 20-minute presentation because the slots were already full. And a big round of applause for Rajat to participate in this presentation. Thank you so much.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much, Rajat. So, good afternoon all. I'm sorry I'm standing between you and your coffee, which is 20 minutes from now. I was very amazed by what Automation Anywhere is doing. That reminded me of GitHub. A person named Narcos has updated some of his projects. One of the projects was he has copied his co-workers' work on it. His co-workers has actually automated nearly everything. Anything that takes more than 17 seconds he has automated, including sending his wife an SMS that he is going to be late for the home. So I hope Automation Anywhere can come up with something like that in future for us.
And also remind us and send them birthday wishes.
Yeah, birthday wishes.
To the right wife.
This is being recorded.
So with that, I take this up with my topic, which is performance testing of IoT world. This is one of the case studies that I personally worked upon. I am from performance testing background, so I can talk much about this topic, but I will just take 20 minutes of yours. This is my profile, which Ali just summarized, so I would skip this. So this is a scenario. Just imagine a scenario that a person is operated on the cardiac stuff, maybe a bypass stuff, maybe a something very critical to the heart ailment. Now, there is a device called CRT, something very near to pacemaker was corporate company in the morning, which would keep on monitoring your heartbeat, and in case anything is going wrong or out of control, it is capable enough to give you electric shocks so that you don't die. I mean, your heart doesn't stop. So that's the beauty of the device. So until I worked upon this project, I was not so much convinced that why IoT and why do we need even performance testing of IoT. But then I realized that this device, the working of this all of the devices together, like Fitbit. This Fitbit would just monitor what you are eating, how you are exercising, how many hours are you dosing, and would send it across to your consulting doctor. Similarly, it will send the data to a dietitian. Now, dietitian would see what you have been eating in last 1 week, 2 weeks, and what you are supposed to going to eat in next 1 week, and it will upload it to your robotic cook. This is all real case study. And this cook would actually cook food for you, and you have to eat only that food. But the beauty is, now the mission critical stuff starts. Take an example that you are at your work, and the person who has just got operated at his home alone and gets a heart attack. So immediately CRT would try to revive the patient. But who knows, would he survive, would he not survive? So out of this heart attack scenario, CRT, the patient has nearly 6 minutes to 15 minutes window to get attended. If he doesn't get attended, he might lose his life. So now the critical scenario starts. So that's where now I started understanding how performance testing is required. So this CRT device would inform the mobile device. Mobile device would inform the hospital service. All is automated. Hospital service will immediately dispatch an ambulance. Ambulance will take the shortest route to reach the patient. And everybody, including the doctor, standby doctor, the hospitalization service, the paramedics, would have access to your medical history. What medicines you have been taking? What are you allergic to something? And what should be given to you when you are, when the paramedics reach you? And if that's not all, once ambulance picks you up and takes you to the hospital, before ambulance reaches the hospital, the insurance company would be notified automatically. Insurance company would pay your charges for the initial deposit, that before you reach the hospital, your payment is done, so you don't have to worry anything. And the last thing, it would contact your in case of emergency. It will make a contact to your in case of emergency contacts, would update them, hey, something is going wrong with this patient. He's already admitted and the treatment is on. So that's how IoT devices work actually. Now let me get into more details. Let's say I have to test this IoT world. So what can be the probable IoT testing areas? It can be integration, it can be many other stuff. But for me, the most important part was performance, being a performance testing guy. So earlier I thought, okay, it was response time, that's all. Web services, that's all. But that's not the case. It's a lot bigger than what we can think of. Say one of the example, device temperature. If you had come across YouTube videos where they test different devices on different temperature, like if you take iPhone 6S and Samsung Galaxy S6, put it into a boiling water for next 60 seconds and observe what happens. iPhone 6S dies within first 10 seconds. It will switch off. While Samsung S6 would keep on running for next 60 seconds. But when you take both the devices out of the boiling water and try to switch it on, iPhone would switch on, but Samsung would not. So why I'm giving you this data? The data is important because everything is now on device. This is mission critical. I mean, anything that goes wrong would cost you a life. So the application which is running on the device has to ensure it doesn't raise the temperature of the device so much. It doesn't eat up the space. It doesn't eat up the CPU RAM. Response time is just one of the aspects. So that gave me a whole different dimension that what should be the performance of this application. So let's really look at the problem definition again. So for me, the data flow was everything is through a mobile device and rest everything is cloud. So one of the first version that we thought was everything would be routed through the device, and device would directly talk to different services, making an asynchronous contact. So one of the problems. Other can be, this device can have its own cloud, and then cloud would have synchronous contacts with all the different clouds, so that anything if goes wrong, the session is alive among all the clouds. So the delay, even of 1 second, is not there. This was just a thought. But how do you prove it? Performance testing comes into picture. But what should be the approach? How would you do a performance testing of this kind of an application with so many integrations, so many devices, device possibilities? So that is how I came into picture. We analyzed the situation. The development process was agile. So it was a 2 weeks development cycle. So earlier it was thought that we should performance test only when the application is ready, even at least the first working functional version is ready. But I said no, we should not. We should start from the beginning. So what was my approach? You create a working prototype of this application. What is working prototype? Working prototype is you do not have any SQL queries, any the codes that you write. You just have basic codes, you just have basic diagram or basic application, but on the platform. See, if you're creating a Java software, if you're using Eclipse, or if you're writing the code yourself, there's a difference. Eclipse would have its own APIs. If you're using C, or if you're using Visual C, there's a difference. What if you're the application that you're trying to make, Visual C is a bottleneck, and not your code or not your SQL queries. So that is what we start with over here. We try to understand what is the basic issue. So you create your screens, you create your prototype. Let's do a performance test. Let's understand how it is happening. Based on the results, then you realize what your designing phase. You blueprint your designing. You blueprint your coding. You start again. And once you are done with the first version, first function stable version, you give it to me. I performance test with further more complexities. First is with stubs and drivers. I do not want it to integrate with any other online application. Second is without any network or without any device, that is simulators. So once I do a performance test, I get a delta. Next is with actual integration, device and network simulation. Next is with integration and with actual devices. So I get three different readings. Now I know what would happen if I use simulators, what correction I need to do, what if I do a stubs and drivers. Now I can take an agile process, keep on iterating, and I can perform a test without worrying what would happen going forward, because I know what is the delta of all three. So, and lastly, once the version is active, at least it is ready to go live, you can do a full-fledged performance test with all the devices, all the integration, correct your data, correct your delta, and do a performance monitoring, active performance monitoring. You cannot keep on testing your integration points. You have to have monitoring in picture. So you keep on monitoring all the monitoring points, and then you analyze how your system is going. So one of the findings of this activity was, do not have this app on the cloud. It should have all the asynchronous contacts. Reason being, the clouds have their own downtimes. So if these clouds clash, the downtime clash, the session would expire. So the thought process, earlier thought process that we had, that shall we have an active session on all the clouds, was negated, because that was not actually helping us save any time. Rather, it was the bottleneck on us, because we were hosting that cloud. So that is how we understood, no, that's not the right thing. This is the right thing. Let's have an asynchronous contact. Let's have performance testing done. And let's go live. So that's a basic basic my approach. Till here, any questions before I go ahead? Any questions on performance testing approach? Okay. Obviously, in the whole gambit, we came across challenges. These challenges include multi-vendor. When you're working with multiple vendors, performance testing is the toughest task. People would not take the blame on themselves. Even if I go to insurance cloud and say, this mistake is yours, they would say, you are writing the wrong code. Correct it. So that's the first challenge. Next biggest challenge would be the standardization. Because different clouds have different ways of working and different IoT devices would have different ways of working, you would not have single communication protocol between different IoT devices. Since this is the gambit of IoT devices, it's not an easy task to ensure there's a standardization, standard protocol of them communicating and you getting working on a mission critical application. So I can count many other challenges, but just to summarize, and I would not take much of your time before you move into your coffee break. Idea is early involvement, anytime you go for an app performance test. Next is you ensure you have major focus on performance monitoring. Keep on monitoring as much as possible. Third is always focus on stable version. Do not try to test unstable version. Prototype testing would yield you a lot of information even before you have to go live. So do a performance test on prototype version itself. As per the data of Forrester, for mix and match of different types of applications, cost of performance testing and fixing during designing phase is 184,000. That's just the data for aggregation of all the different kind of applications across globe. While in production or maybe UAT phase, it is 1,000-1,000. So that's a ratio of 80-82%. So you are going to increase your cost to 82% if you do not have an early involvement for performance. So that's all I would say for today.
Thank you so much, Rajat. That was very, very sweet. Very interesting, I would say. Very short, very sweet. Thank you so much. Can I invite Meenakshi? Can you come on the stage?
I have a question, Adi.
Yes.
Yes, sorry, I didn't ask you. Yeah, my mistake.
I have a question. So early involvement and functionally stable product, aren't they opposite to each other?
The prototype version is an early involvement. Second is you always do incremental development. Even if it is agile, even if it is non-agile. You do an incremental development. When you say incremental development, whenever you develop something, it has to be at least stable enough. Then it can be released for maybe SIT. So those versions should be considered for performance.
So again, coming back to early involvement, how early would that begin in that case?
My suggestion always is you start as early as possible. I mean, the mantra that we follow is we can start doing performance evaluation once you just have the concept of an application. You have just not prepared the application, but just a concept. Because when you have a concept, you say, I want to do an application on Java plus SQL. Or my database could be 50,000 gigabytes. My first answer would be, don't go for SQL, go for Oracle. So there itself I can tell you where things can go wrong.
Good, thank you. Any more queries, guys? Any more questions? Can I ask you one question before I call upon Meenakshi? What is IoT? So, around you, have you seen IoT being there somewhere? Have you seen an IoT implementation around you somewhere? Where? Really? Very nice. So that's a great example. Anybody else? Brilliant. Like, what would you like to monitor?
CCTV camera.
Yeah.
Again, it's a business use case. We need to be understanding. See, being and in the morning session as well, when we're talking about behavior, which Amol was presenting, right? Unless and until we understand the behavior, no application and no solutions or no automation will be successful around that. So, yeah, monitoring what? And you want monitoring going live? You mean you will be always watching on your mobile phone that somebody is entering? How do you want that to be implemented?
No, whenever I go.
So would it make sense, suppose the guy breaks in and obviously you're not monitoring at that time, would it make sense?
Intrusion.
Intrusion. Right, so anything else?
So
what Rajat mentioned, the Fitbit band.
Yes, so all of you wearing Fitbits has got a chance to show it now. I don't have. And how does it help? See, it is right now at your individual level. But then what happens is that if it gets connected to a medical application, and then you start getting updates, and then it gets connected to your Aadhaar card, and then it gets connected to your insurance company, and then the premium goes up if you're not walking enough. Right? Are you understanding the complexity?
The
robotic skills. And how many Aadhaar cards are there in India today?
More than the population of India.
80% of Indian, I don't know exactly what the population is right now, but the claim is that it's been a huge number. I think it is at least 10 crore odd Aadhaar cards existing. And if we have basically all kind of financial inclusions and insurance and everything getting tied to that, not only you will have to pick up the data, you have to look at all your Fitbits, you have to look at everything around that, and then we are talking about which problem?
Big data.
Thank you so much. And that's what I wanted to come. Thank you so much. Can we have a big round of applause for Rajat? Thanks. Thank you, Minashi. And one request.